New data from UAE-based property firm Cavendish Maxwell shows Dubai house prices fell to their lowest levels in June, not seen since the 2008 financial meltdown. It appears a housing bust has been unfolding across Dubai for some time. A record number of residential units are expected to come online in the holiday 2019 will push Dubai property prices even lower. The bust is expected last through 2020. So is a Dubai default coming? In a repeat of Dubai's default of $25 billion Nikhil debt in 2008, Dubai government suspends all legal cases against Maiden, owned by Ruler, since June 2019. Major global media confirms our view of the massive financial crisis afflicting Dubai. Talks trade and tourism decline, civil wars, Iran tensions, 60,000 residential units plus 54,000 hotel rooms to be delivered in 2019. Things are coming to a head. Add to this the six civil wars ongoing in the Middle East and Levant region. 1. Syria. 2. Iraq. 3. Yemen. 4. Palestine. 5. Libya. 6. Afghanistan. Not to mention bans on Iranian airspace, terror alerts for most of Middle East, sanctions on Iran, rivalries and bans on each other in Middle East, bombings of ships passing through and all sorts of problems from Iran oil sanctions to rising insurance costs to navies and drones attacking everyone in the Strait of Hormuz. Now they are going to start a seventh one. On September 2, 2019, Bahrain instructs citizens to leave Lebanon over security incidents. The golden pot of honey and money finished in 2008 and finally bankrupted in 2015. Now Saudis and Emiratis run around the world with a borrowing hat in their hands. And they will ensure that whoever comes with their money over their lees with nothing but pain and misery that too via a jail cell, which is now the only way to leave Dubai and Saudi Arabia. Dubai had powers until 2008, once they defaulted, Abu Dhabi took over immigration policy, changed stance, paid salaries to Dubai police, supported four emirates of Ras Al Khaimah, Ajman, Sharjah etc. by giving them infrastructures, to buy peace and loyalty, and set up oil pipeline in Fujairah. In 2012, Abu Dhabi took over all foreign affairs, defense, immigration affairs and went ballistic against Iran, Syria, Libya, Bangladesh and more, and banned all of them and deported thousands. In 2017, in cahoots with Saudis, they went ballistic against Qatar and banned and insulted them. Dubai has completely lost all its power since 2012, whatever remained after the 2008 default. Dubai was always dependent on foreign investors, whether Arabs or Iranians or anyone else. Since 2012, all that money disappeared. Hence, Dubai turned into a criminal's paradise. There is not one country in this world whose criminals do not keep millions or billions in Dubai. Dubai needs it, but Abu Dhabi doesn't. However, everyone has deserted or left or caught or has assets frozen or lost 60 to 80% value if invested in Dubai. Last week the God of Diamonds fled from Dubai. Once Dubai reached the end of rope in 2015, they succumbed even further and Abu Dhabi took over everything. The Dubai ruler is in Abu Dhabi more frequently than ever before, and various princes and family members are fleeing. Princess Haya, Dubai ruler's wife and four kids, have fled to London to seek protection. Almost all rulers of various emirates disagree with Abu Dhabi because their sons and citizens are being sent for slaughter in the war in Yemen, business has collapsed, war is all around them. And from an Iranian source, Fujairah prince ran away to Qatar. Abu Dhabi was also behind the death of son of Sharjah Emir in London. It was certainly not sex and drugs. He was very educated and my sources say that he disagreed with his parents, who both have PhDs, about the direction the United Arab Emirates is taking regarding the war in Yemen and the tensions with Iran. Finally, you must read this to know who is the brains behind entire Middle East fiasco, and it is indeed Abu Dhabi. The most powerful Arab ruler isn't Mohammed bin Salman aka MBS, it is Mohammed bin Zayed aka MBZ. Dubai tried to be a wannabe and failed miserably since its default in 2008, and the coming collapse of Dubai will shake the entire world to its core once they default this time around. Dubai old tagline, Buy Dubai. Dubai new tagline, Buy Buy Dubai. This was the Atlantis Report. Please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.